What is going on, people? We are back at the tabletop, and today we're taking another look at the H&K 416. And unfortunately, it's not a real 416. It is the licensed Umarex-made copy from H&K, but this thing is absolutely awesome. You guys could check back on some of my previous videos that I have on it. It's been flawless in its function. Its form is amazing. It's actually aluminum instead of polymer like the M&P 1522 and stuff like that, and it's a sick little rig. Plus, they were doing the pistol configuration far before Smith & Wesson was, and they are doing it better. 20 and 30 shot mags, easily available, SBA-3 on there, and I bought this gun because, for one, it's cool, and 416s, for the most part, are unobtainium. You can get an MR556 and, you know, do certain stuff to it and make it as close as possible, but it's never going to be the real deal. Practically speaking, you know, Brownells did have some parts kits or whatever, but yada, 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 regardless. They're super affordable. It's a 22. It can easily be used as a trainer for your go-to-war gun, your fighting gun, your defensive gun. You could set it up exactly how you have your real rifle set up. Not that you have to go put a aim point or a whatever on, you know, a $400-something 22, which is why I have a SIG MSR on it, but, you know, it's a red dot, right? So, flashlight mounted in the same position on the rail, different stuff like that. The magazines go into standard AR mag pouches. Plus, you've got the same capacity. The gun itself, and then with the brace, shout out to TLO Outdoors, for sending out the sling. Awesome, awesome. I'm a huge, everybody always shits on the paracord shit. Well, for one, this has a fire starter in it, a whistle. It did have a compass, but the compass broke. It's not like a fashion thing, dude. Like, I'm an EDC gear junkie. Like, I just wear the shit because it is useful, and I've had to actually use a paracord bracelet before in real life, so you can't tell me shit about, oh, you're never gonna use it. So having some paracord, definitely not a half bad idea. For sure, because it definitely comes in handy, and I'm not going to complain. Plus, it worked out perfectly. The QD mounts go right on the rail, right into the SBA-3 brace. And then I picked this up because Kyle had ordered it for his M&P 1522. And he's kind of making like a little clone out of the, I guess, the rig that he runs in, what is it called? What the hell is it? Rainbow Six Siege, because he's a freaking nerd boy. But it was the wrong one, and I was like, dude, that would look sick on the 416, so I'll take it. And it's a fake can, fake suppressor, but it looks real enough, you know, for pictures and shit and just playing around. It's cool. It's a 22. It will, I guess, technically make it slightly quieter because you're pushing the blast is further away. Blast, it's a fucking 22. But the, I mean, the sound, it's going to be further away from the shooter now. Which, you know, whatever, dude. But it's just a sick little setup. Like, this is an awesome gun. It looks cool. Trainer, you could go take a class with this if you can't afford to take a class with a 5.56 gun, especially now because of ammo prices, but you want to keep up, you know, training and stuff. You could get something like this and run 22s. It's going to be far more affordable. And no, you're not getting the recoil management and this, that, and the third, but the fundamentals, you know, getting yourself on target, follow-up shots, reloading the gun, manipulating the gun, and if anything, you're probably going to have more problems with a 22, so you're going to get more malfunction clearance drills in. It's not a half-bad way to do it if whoever's class you are taking will allow you to do so. One thing about Jaeger, shout out to Jaeger, is that I've heard him say before on his videos that if you can't afford to come take a class with a full-power rifle, which he advises doing, people not being cheap, he's got no problem with you coming out and training with whatever you got, 22, whatever you could afford, just to get it done, because the training is the more important thing. The repetitions are the more important thing. So, anyway, back to why I bought this. For one, for the training purposes, and it's just cool, and I'm an H&K nerd, and I wanted to do something like this. I want to make it like a little Benghazi clone. From my understanding, they were running 416s. I think there were 10-inch guns. This is an 8-inch barrel, so it's not exact, but that was the only offering. And set it up. I do have the Hollow Sun little Steiner D-ball laser thing, the clone, coming soon. That's going to be ran on this gun. I'm going to put, I mean, I don't know what light I'm going to put on there. Hopefully not a $400 Surefire, but that would be cool. do it just for the memes, I suppose. Weird flex, but all right. And then maybe, like, I want to buy an EOTech, and it would look cool on this gun, but, you know, I'd take it on and off. I'd put it on something a little bit more serious. But honestly, with as reliable as this freaking gun has been for me, literally never cleaned it once. Have shot it thousands of times, just like the Kel-Tec P17, and this thing has never had a single issue. There was one time I even fed a whole magazine through of longs, not long rifles, longs, and it cycled and fed perfectly fine. It's an awesome gun. It's an accurate gun. The iron sights came dead on out of box. The trigger is not the nicest trigger for a 22 rifle, but it's also simulating closer to what a mil-spec rat grade AR trigger is. So at that point, it's better for training. It's cool because this is the same actual pistol grip that they put on the MR556 and the 416. It's got the storage compartment underneath. So that's the real deal. You can take this off and bolt it on your AR if you want. They give you the flip-up irons, which are polymer, but they work. Got no problem with them. Putting the little fake can on there is cool. I like the look, especially with the shorter barrel. You know, it looks good, and it's starting to get a little bit closer to what I want to do. I don't want to dump a whole bunch of money into it to have it be an exact clone of like a Benghazi gun. And it's just a 22 and not like an actual fighting gun or range gun or training gun or whatever. Although it's a training gun, and it's a fighting gun if you have to make it a fighting gun. Like I said, I've had nothing but top-notch reliability out of it. And you fill those mags, you got good capacity. You fill those mags with some Stangers or some goddamn Velocitors or something. Aguila makes a super extra smoking hot load, too. I mean, that's a bunch of little bee stings. You put them in the right spot, dude. People are going to have an allergic reaction, to say the least, you know? You could modularize it, light, dot, backup irons, common ergonomic controls. The only thing with the 416s from H&K that everybody gripes about is this is just for show. The bolt release, bolt hold open, the paddle does not push. It doesn't work. It's got nothing to do with nothing. You got to run the charging handle every time. I'm not opposed to that because I typically run the charging handle regardless, because you're getting full spring compression, and if the gun was to be dirty or there was junk in there or whatever's going on, plus, you know, it's going to be simple. It's going to work, you know. I don't know. It just seems like the more easy way to do it, but I'm not opposed to this. I use this on my real guns and other guns that have it, but I got no problem just running the charging handle. So, you know, that's the biggest gripe anybody really ever has to say about these things, but they're accurate, they're reliable, they're well-made, better-made than the Smith & Wesson, just because of the fact that this is actual aluminum, okay? So you've got weight there. It feels like an actual gun. It's going to simulate your real AR pistol or SBR a lot closer than the Smith & Wesson will. Nice thick barrel on there, and I don't believe that it's sleeved. I mean, that's a steel barrel all the way back. Just direct thread. They give you the adapter. It's a tiny 22 thread in there, and then they give you the half by 28. And the muzzle brake or flash hider that this thing actually ships with is steel or aluminum or something. But I mean, it's half by 28. You could take that off. It's a four prong, and put it on a real 5.56 gun or whatever. So I don't know. I dig this thing. I think this is the coolest 22 rifle, pistol, whatever, on the market. And I think it's one of the best made ones. And I'm probably going to pick up the MP5 SD that they're putting out now just to have a fun little plinker, which this can do all day long. It's a great trainer for new shooters. Get them to learn the AR-15 and the controls for cheap. No recoil, less sound. It's less scary to them. It's less intimidating. And they get this down. They learn how to shoot the iron sights. They learn how to shoot the dot. They learn how to use the safety and all that. Change the mags. And then you got them running a 5.56 gun, and it's like on autopilot. So not a bad idea whatsoever. I will do more updates as I bolt more crap to the gun, and we're going to do some more range videos. Might even be filming some later today. I don't know when I'm going to post them, but I love this gun. It's awesome. And if you guys have the opportunity and you're looking for something like this, I highly advise this over the Smith any day of the week. The Smith is a fine gun. It works. This is just way nicer, and honestly, most of the time, you could actually get this cheaper. But anyway, that's the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching a little bit of gun porn, a little bit of 22 clone build geek porn. Geek porn. Oh, geez. Now I'm going to get demonetized for that. We got Velma stripping in the background. But yeah, I like it. I think it's sick. I have fun with it. It shoots really, really good. And it eats anything. The nice high-end, you know, velocity-based stuff all the way to the cheap bucket of bullets bullshit. So you should pick one up for sure. And that's not me just being an HK fanboy. And trust me, they don't give me a dime back of my money that I spend with them. But either way, I appreciate you guys being here. Make sure you check out the first three links in the description box below. Because if everybody stood up in this country and fought for their rights, maybe in Illinois, this wouldn't have to be fake. Okay? This wouldn't have to be fake in Illinois if everybody stood up and fought for their rights. So make sure you do that. The first three links in the description box below are a great place to start. Furthermore, if you like what I do here, you want to help support the channel, there's a bunch of great ways to do that in the description box below, and I'll probably have something pinned in the comment section. But either way, most importantly, fight for your rights. I appreciate you being here. Make sure you smash the like button. Share the video with your friends. If you got a friend looking for a 22, this might be the one. Make sure you are subscribed, because YouTube keeps unsubscribing my subscribers from being subscribed to me. And I'd rather resent that, YouTube. And make sure you ring the notification bell. I'm posting content like every day, people. Every day. And do you really want to miss that? Do you really want to miss cool stuff like that? Absolutely cool guns and gear and gadgetry. All types of just freedom-oriented content. Here in this country, in America, you would want to miss that. Sounds like communism to me, folks. We'll catch you later.